Now, today class, we will discuss about availability, ready state, Kelvin plot, and also closure statements. So, what is available and unavailable energy? So, in the operation of any reversible heat engine, we have seen that a portion of heat supplied from a high temperature reservoir or the heat source must be rejected to a sink at lower temperature. We have seen this from our earlier discussion. We have to supply the heat in a reversible heat engine, and a portion of heat supplied from a high constant temperature reservoir, that is called as the heat source, must be rejected to the heat sink, which is at lower temperature T2, and this is T1. So, for all practical purposes, there is a minimum value of sink temperature which can be considered in most cases, and this normally corresponds to the temperature of atmospheric air or the large body of water. So, for the heat engine to be operated or to produce the work, it is necessary that it will take some heat from the heat source, it convert it into the work, and some portion will be rejected to the surrounding, that is the heat sink. So, generally, if we say any system employed by the engineers must be operated within the Earth's atmosphere, and the temperature and pressure of the atmosphere impose a limit over the extent to which a given form of energy can be converted to the work. It means when an engine will work, it will be operated within the Earth atmosphere. And so definitely to convert it, the heat into the work, it will require a high temperature reservoir, a low temperature reservoir, then it can convert the heat into the work. It will require some system to which it will eject heat, otherwise it is not possible at all. So first you have to understand what is the available energy and what is unavailable energy. So first, this is the available energy. Available energy is that part of energy, it is that part of energy which can be converted into work, the part of energy that can be converted into work by ideal processes which reduce the system to a dead state, a state in equilibrium with earth and atmosphere. So that part of energy which can be converted into the work is called as the available energy, and it is done by the ideal process. And okay, also we say another term which is called as the unavailable energy. It is that part of energy which cannot be converted into work by ideal process, and which reduce the system to a dead state, a state in equilibrium with earth and atmosphere. So just try to understand what is the available energy and what is unavailable energy. So here, as we have seen earlier, that a heat engine, suppose there is a heat engine, and as we know that this is the heat source, and from heat source heat is taken, that this heat source, it is maintained at temperature T1, and there is a heat sink. It is maintained at temperature T2. Our system will work within this limit, temperature limit T1 and T2. Here definitely T1 is greater than T2. Suppose there is a thermodynamic system, that is, this is a heat engine, and which is working in a cyclic process. So this heat engine, that it is taking some amount of heat, suppose it is Q1, and which is equal to 100 kilojoules. This amount of heat is being taken, and this is rejecting Q2, which is equal to suppose it is 40 kilojoules of heat, it is rejecting to the heat sink or the surrounding, and then this engine is producing W net equal to what is the amount? It is 60 kilojoules. Okay. So here we are seeing that we have taken 100 kilojoules of the heat from the heat source. We have rejected 40 kilojoules of heat to the heat sink, but we could convert only 60% of this heat into the work. So this the amount of energy that can be converted into work, this 60 kilojoules that can be converted into work, this is called as the available energy. Energy that is available or that can be converted into work is called as the available energy.
Energy
that can be converted to work, this part only can be converted to work, but this 40 kilojoules, this amount cannot be converted into work, but it will be rejected to the heat sink or to the surrounding. So this part, this cannot be converted into the work. Why we are going to reject it? Because this part cannot be converted into work, so it is going to reject it to the heat sink. This is called as the unavailable energy.
Yes, sir.
Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
And it is not possible that we can convert completely 100 kilojoules into the work, because that follows the first law, but this would be the second law. Okay? So it should be clear to you, available energy as well as the unavailable energy. Okay? Now, before going to the next term, just you have to understand what are the different methods we study, which are the dead state, etc. So, here you see, next term is the dead state. What is the dead state? Then you can understand how energy conversion takes place. So, term is the dead state. Dead state actually, the atmosphere of low temperature heat sink. Atmosphere, which is the low temperature heat sink, it is regarded as the most stable state, having the following characteristics. Because atmosphere available everywhere, all the processes are occurring on the ground surface, earth surface. So we use the atmospheric air as the heat sink, and it is having some characteristics. Atmosphere is homogeneous in temperature, pressure and composition. If the temperature is same, not changing, pressure is same, not changing, composition is not changing. Even there are some small changes, but we consider that it is homogeneous throughout. There is no relative motion in its various parts, which are to be considered, and all parts are at the same level, because all the equipment we are using on the earth surface, so all the equipment, all the parts, all the system are at the same level. Because of that, we consider our atmosphere as the stable system, which is in the stable equilibrium. Under such condition, the atmosphere alone cannot produce work. Because as we have seen, some system take heat from the heat source, convert it into the work, and remaining amount is supplied to the heat sink. If there is only heat sink, then it cannot produce any work. It is not possible that its sink itself cannot produce, it can produce any work. So atmosphere alone cannot produce any work. Now suppose that any system employed by an engineer, we are considering any system which is employed by an engineer, and it is within this atmosphere has the following characteristics. There is some system which was employed, and within this atmosphere it has following characteristics. And what are the characteristics? First, it is rest related to the motion. If it is rest, definitely its velocity will be equal to zero. It is in equilibrium with atmosphere. If our system is in equilibrium with the atmosphere, then its pressure, temperature, etc. will be equal to the surrounding temperature. And under this condition, no work will be obtained from interaction between the system and the atmosphere. Now suppose this is our system. This is our system. And our system, and I am going to write, this is our air or the atmosphere. Our atmosphere, right, suppose pressure P0. It's a temperature T0. We are the pressure temperature of the atmosphere. And our system is in equilibrium with this atmosphere. For example, our system is in equilibrium with the atmosphere. And definitely, the pressure of the system will be P naught as well as temperature of the system will also be T naught. What will be same? Because it is in equilibrium. The pressure will be same, so there will be no mass flow. Temperature will be same, there will be no heat flow. So the same is said here. It is in equilibrium with the atmosphere regarding pressure, temperature, etc. Then this system cannot also produce any work if it is in equilibrium with the atmosphere or the heat sink. Okay? So,
yes,
the, so the dead state of a system is defined as the state of stable equilibrium. The dead state of a system is defined as state of stable equilibrium of the system within the atmosphere. And its capacity to do work ceases. Its capacity to do means that system cannot produce any work. Its capacity ceases means that it stops. Capacity to do work will be ceased or stops. And its available energy is zero. It can produce no work at all because it is in still equipped with the surrounding. Earth and atmosphere are regarded in the stable states. I already discussed earth and atmosphere, both are considered as the stable state and they are having the following conditions of the dead state. First condition, the system should be in stable and inert phase. This is requirement. The system should be in stable as well as in inert phase. It should not react with anything. And any phase change or chemical reaction is not possible in the system. If it is in the dead state, then there should be no chemical reaction. The system should have pressure, temperature equal to that of the atmosphere. Another condition is that pressure and temperature of the system should be equal to that of the atmosphere. Its elevation and velocity should be equal to zero. So for the system, if its pressure is P naught, the temperature T naught, its elevation Z also will be equal to zero. Its velocity C also will be equal to zero. VR of the system as well as surrounding both will be same. Then our system is said to be in the state of the dead state. Okay, it can produce no work at all. I'm again going to this term to make it clear, because here you will see this is our heat source, this is our heat sink. System is taking this amount of heat from the surrounding, rejecting this amount of heat to the surrounding. But it is converting 60 kJ amount of heat into work. Now suppose system is at also at the temperature T2, means the heat, the system is also at the temperature T2. So temperature system is T2 and temperature heat sink is also T2. Then can this system reject heat to this sink? Because if the both are at the same temperature, heat cannot flow at the same temperature because it requires the temperature difference. So if our system is at the same temperature, it can produce no work. There should be always some temperature difference, pressure difference. Otherwise, it can produce no work. Then this state of the system is called as the dead state. Dead state means, you understand, dead means not live. Which is not live, it is not, can produce any work. It is having energy, no energy at all. Okay? It clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So, in conclusion with this, now we are taking you here the some statement of the second law. So, first we are taking the Kelvin-Planck statement. Typically, in the second law, we are two statements. One is the Kelvin-Planck statement. Second is the Clausius statement. Kelvin-Planck statement focuses on the heat engine, but the Clausius statement says about the heat pump. So, first statement of the Kelvin-Planck, it says that it is impossible to construct an engine. It is impossible to construct an engine which will work in a complete cycle. Complete cycle produce no other effect except the raising of weight and cooling of heat reservoir. It is impossible. First, this statement says, first, it is impossible to construct at that engine. It's not possible at all. The system which will work in a complete cycle, it will follow a cyclic process. A raising of a weight and cooling of heat reservoir. If we say the raising of a weight, in raising of a weight, we understand it will require some force. And the force will apply to some object, then it will move some through distance d. When we will raise some weight, the weight will move through distance d, and some force will apply f. It means that is the work. Raising of weight means some work is there. Cooling of heat reservoir, when we will take some heat from some system, it will be cooled. So cooling of heat reservoir means we are taking some heat from some system, that is Q1. So it is impossible to construct an engine which will work in a complete cycle. It will produce no other effect excluding raising of weight means the production of the work, and cooling of heat reservoir means taking the heat. It means Q1 should be equal W. Q1 equal to W means both will be same. The amount of heat we are taking to be converted into the work. This is not possible. It is the statement of Calvin Plank. In the other words, we can say no process is possible whose sole effect is the removal of heat from a single thermal reservoir at an uniform temperature and the performance of an equal amount of work. Such process is not possible whose objective is the removal of heat from a single thermal reservoir. Again, removal of heat means that is Q1. And the performance of equal amount of work, so that is W. So no process is possible whose sole effect is removal of heat means taking Q1 and producing W amount of work. So this is also not possible. So both the statements say about
sir, the heat. Sir, what is sole effect?
Sole effect means the, we can say the concentrated effect. Concentrated main effect, theme we can say. Its effect is only to remove the heat and produce the work. It is the main. Okay? Focus effect we can say. Okay?
Sir, and raising of weight means?
Raising of weight, I have written here. W, that is the work. When we raise some weight, we will apply some force. And when the weight will be raised, it will move
yes, to sir.
The so F into D, it will equal to work. You getting my point?
Yes, sir.
So raising of means weight means to produce some work. Okay, connect with the work. Okay. So now suppose here you can see this example. Some heat source is at temperature T1. Then this is some system. Suppose it is the heat engine. It is taking 100 kilojoules of heat from this. Heat source and producing same amount of work, then this case is not possible. Means that we are taking this amount of heat, converting it into same amount of work. It is satisfying only first law, because first law says heat and work are mutually convertible, but it is violating second law. We cannot convert Q into work fully. So this case is not possible. It is not possible. It is impossible to construct such an engine. Here you can see heat source at temperature T1, it takes 100 kilojoules of heat from the heat source, producing 44 kilojoules amount of work and rejecting 60 kilojoules amount of heat to the surrounding. So this case is sort of satisfying second law, because as per the second law, some heat rejection is important. It is necessary. So it is following. Some heat rejection is there. So this is following the second law, but it is not satisfying. Okay. So this statement about the Calvin-Plank statement. Now the similar statement called as the Clausius statement. This statement focusing on the heat pump. So according to the Clausius statement, it is impossible to construct a heat pump. Here we will talk about the heat pump, which also operating in a cycle. The operating cycle will remove heat continuously from a lower temperature reservoir. Heat removing means definitely it will take heat from the lower temperature reservoir. Means we are talking about the Q2. It is taken from the lower temperature reservoir and transferred to the higher temperature reservoir. When we transfer to the higher temperature reservoir, yes, we are talking about the heat Q1. Okay, but without any external amount of work being done. No work it will take. So okay, and in the other words we can say no process possible whose sole effect is the removal of heat from the heat reservoir, the same meaning, and the absorption of equal amount of heat by reservoir at higher temperature. Means heat will be taken from the lower temperature reservoir, that means the heat sink, and absorption of the that heat by a higher temperature reservoir means heat source. So this is at T1 and this is at T2. Okay. Now one more statement of that that can be written here. Heat itself cannot flow from a colder body to a hotter body. Itself will not flow. It will require some work input. So you can see here, this is some heat source and this is heat sink. And if you say Q2 equal to 100 kilojoule amount of heat is being taken from this heat sink, and the same amount of heat is being supplied to the heat source. No work input is here. No work input is here. This case is not possible. Heat itself cannot flow from the low temperature reservoir to the high temperature reservoir. It is violating second law.
High temperature.
Yeah, but in the second case, 60 kilojoule of heat being taken from the heat sink, we are requiring or taking 40 kilojoules amount of the work input and supplying or transferring 100 kilojoules amount of heat to the heat source. This case is possible. It is satisfying the second law. So actually, this is the closest statement says this type of engine is not possible. This case is not possible. We cannot construct such an heat pump which will remove the heat and transfer heat to the heat source without taking any external amount of the work heat. This case is not possible. Okay. Now come to the another point. So here, that is the perpetual motion machine of the second kind. Yeah.
सर ये सेकंड वाला थोड़ा समझ में नहीं आया
ओके सो नो नो इन द सेकंड केस दिस नथिंग इट इज द प्रैक्टिकल केस यू ऑलरेडी स्टडीड वी आर अटेंडिंग माय क्लास यू स्टडी दिस इज द फॉर द हीट पंप एंड दिस एंड दिस इज फॉर द हीट पंप एंड इफ द डायरेक्शन यू रिवर्स दैट इज फॉर द हीट इंजन वी आर टेकिंग 60 किलोजूल अमाउंट ऑफ हीट फ्रॉम द हीट सिंक We are taking 40 kilojoules of the work done as a work input, and then 40 plus 60 is 100 kilojoule is being transferred to the heat source. So this is called as the heat pump operation of the heat pump on which our refrigerator and air conditioner are working. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, but ये सर ये आपने बोला कि सर colder body से मतलब heat वाली body में मतलब heat नहीं transfer होगी. सर कुछ तो मतलब स्मॉल अमाउंट ऑफ हीट तो ट्रांसफर होगी ना सर
यू आर नॉट अटेंडिंग
सर वो लास्ट वाला स्टेटमेंट जो है सर
थर्ड वाला यू आर नॉट अटेंडिंग माय क्लासेस
यस सर
यू आर नॉट अटेंडिंग
आर यू तीसरा कौन सा है
और यू आर मिसिंग
माय यस सर नो सर
यू आर मिसिंग माय क्लासेस और नॉट
नो सर पढ़ लेता हूं सर
Okay. Okay, I will discuss later. First, understand this perpetual motion.
Okay, sir.
So, perpetual motion machine of second kind. It is impossible to construct a perpetual motion machine of second kind. Means to construct this machine, this is called as a PMM2. It is impossible. Now, what is PMM2? A perpetual motion machine of the second kind is one which operates in a cycle. It is following a cycle process and delivers an equal amount of work equal to the heat extracted from the single thermal reservoir at uniform temperature. To construct such machine is not possible. This PMM2 is that machine which will operate in a cycle, will deliver the amount of work equal to heat extracted. Means if we have extracted Q amount of heat from the heat source, then it will convert it into work. That is PMM2. PMM2 means this machine will take Q amount of heat and it will convert the whole amount of heat into the work. Construction of this machine is not possible. This is the rule for the perpetual motion machine of the second type. Got it? Perpetual motion machine of second kind means the machine which is operating in a cycle. You take this example, this is the perpetual motion machine of second kind. Here, suppose this is our PMM2. For example, this is our PMM2. I am going to write here, it is the PMM2. Okay? Now, this machine is taking 100 closure of heat and 100 closure of heat. Oh, this is about the heat. Take this example, not that. Yeah, this is our PMM2. Here, this machine is taking 100 closure of heat. And converting, and if it is converting, it will be equal to also W equal to 100 kilojoules. Yes. Q and W both will be same. The whatever the amount of heat being taken will be converted to work. This is the right example, the PMM2. We have taken this amount from the heat source and converted into the amount of the work. So this is called as the PMM2. To construct such machine is not possible. Because
yes, sir.
There is no heat sink. This is not possible. It will require the two injectors. Okay.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
It is very simple. It is impossible to construct a turbine motion machine of the second kind, means which will operate in a cycle, deliver amount of work equal to heat extracted. Deliver means it will produce the work equal to what? Heat extracted. What will you say? Q equal to W. That machine is not possible. This is the statement of the second law, which is called as the perpetual motion machine of second type. Now there is some principle of degradation of energy. The available energy of an isolated system decreases in all real processes and it is conserved in ideal processes. Similarly, as a result of the natural process, energy instantly becomes less available for the performance of work. Meaning is that available energy, it means you understand that is the work. Okay? It is the work. Yeah. Then,
yes, sir.
Some system passes through some real process. Then it will reject some heat. So its energy level will decrease. Energy level will decrease. When we are converting heat into work, its energy level will decrease. So the available energy of an isolated system will decrease in all real processes and is conserved in ideal processes. Ideal means the process which are reversible. But the reversible process are not possible at all. So we are considered as the ideal. All the processes which are occurring, they are the real process or the actual process. So the available energy always decreases. But we consider if the process is ideal, then its available energy will be constant. So I will make it clear here. Suppose this is the piston and the cylinder arrangement. And we know that here, suppose this is some gas. And this gas is initially having its pressure is P1 and temperature is T1. So when this gas will expand, when the piston will move here, it will produce some work. Gas will expand. Suppose now our piston has been moved here or is here. This position is 1-1, initial position. And after moving, the second position or the final position is 2-2. So you will see at this position 2-2, the pressure is now P2 and temperature is now T2. Definitely here, pressure P2 is less than P1 after expansion and temperature will also decrease. So T2 is less than T1. My point, so what is happening here from 1 to 2? What is happening? What changes are occurring? Means the energy level which was at point 1 has been reduced to at point 2. Means some energy has been converted into the work. You are getting or not?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Means the available energy of the system decreases because it is passing through some process. That's why here is the expansion. Process is expansion. So when our system is passing through some process, then definitely its energy level will decrease. And it is from this level, from the pressure will decrease to T1 to T2. Temperature will decrease given to T2 means now the available energy after passing this process is the less energy. You are getting? So consider, suppose when you attend first class, when you enter the, in the first class, you are having the full energy. Is it okay?
Yes.
But after attending three periods before the lunch, you check your level. What is the energy level of yourself from the first period to the after the third period? You will feel your energy level has been decreased.
Yes, sir.
So you are the system. So you have passed through some process. And after passing, even definitely you have produced some, you have got some knowledge. But still, what has happened? Your energy level has been decreased. Means your available energy is now degraded. You are having the less energy. Energy level is decreasing. And at the end of the day, you are having the very small amount of energy. And at the night, when you are going to sleep, approximately you can say you are having no energy at all. Just you want to take your sleep. That all of energy has been exhausted. You are in the, we can say it is in the dead state. You can produce no work,
yes,
now.
Sir.
You are not ready to work any work now. It means,
yes, sir,
if you are passing through, yes, any process, your available energy will decrease continuously.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so this is the meaning. As a result, yes, of, similarly here also says, as a result of natural process. Natural process means that process occurring naturally. It is also the real process. In this process also, energy will be less available. If any system passing through any process, energy will be less available. This is the law called as the principle of degradation of energy. If the level of energy decreases, it means what is happening? Degradation of the energy is there. Energy will degrade. If you work more and more, your energy level will be decreasing. Same thing here also. Okay. Then again, second is that principle of increase of entropy.
Entropy.
So entropy of an isolated system increases. Entropy of an isolated system increases. I will discuss you more further. Entropy means you can say about the disorder or the randomness. It is called delta disorder or the randomness. So entropy of an isolated system increases means disorder increases in all real processes, but is conserved in ideal processes. Any system passing through real processes, then entropy will increase, but in ideal processes, entropy is conserved. It is similar to the earlier one. When the system will pass, it will pass through some real process, then entropy will increase. Entropy will increase means there will be more and more disorder. The less energy will be there. Entropy more means less available energy. We can produce the less amount of work. It means, suppose we are giving some heat to the ice, then definitely ice will melt. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
We are giving some heat to the ice will melt. But you compare, molecules of the ice are arranged in a systematic manner. They are in the, yes, better order. But when it will form the water, the molecules of the water particles are at the far apart. They are having the more freedom. They are having the more free movement.
Yes.
Yeah. If we further give heat to the water, it will form the vapor.
Are you right?
But the particles of the vapor are more apart. They are more having the freedom. They are having the more disorder. In this way, we can say,
yes,
by giving the heat, the disorder is increasing. It means the entropy of the system is increasing. And it is happening in all real processes. But in ideal process, it is that is entropy is conserved in ideal process. Actually, ideal process is called as a reversible process. That can be reversed. Ideal means,
yes,
reversible process. But no reversible process is possible at all. No reversible process possible at all, so it is called like the ideal process because of the friction, etc., and some other reasons. So all the processes are the natural process, and because of that, entropy will increase continuously. There will be less availability of the work. Any system passing through any process, definitely entropy will increase. Available energy will decrease, and available energy will increase. Disorder will increase. So these are the some points about the available energy as well as unavailable energy, or the entropy and the principle of degradation of energy, as well as we will also discuss about the PMM2. Okay. Next, we are taking the point that Kelvin and Clausius statements, these are the two statements, and it seems that both our statements are different, but actually they are the same. Clausius statement says about the heat pump. Kelvin-Planck statement says about the heat engine. It seems that both are different, but they are the same. If we violate one statement, it will also violate another. Means if we violate Clausius statement, automatically Kelvin-Planck statement will be violated. And if we violate Kelvin-Planck statement, Clausius statement will be violated automatically. So there is the equivalence of Kelvin-Planck and Clausius statement. So this now first we are taking the violation of Kelvin-Planck statement. So violation of violation of Kelvin-Planck statement. Means if we will violate this statement, another one, that is the Clausius statement, will also be violated. That we have to prove. It is called actually the equivalence of Kelvin-Planck and Clausius statement. There is a violation of Kelvin-Planck statement. Now see here, this is the heat source. Our heat source is there, and let this heat source is at temperature T1, okay? And there is some heat sink. Heat sink. And heat sink at temperature T2. Now there are two systems, that one system is there, that is, this is the heat engine. This is operating in a cycle. This heat engine is taking Q1 amount of heat from the heat source, and suppose this heat engine is rejecting Q2 equals to zero amount of heat to the heat sink. There is another system, which is the heat pump. This heat pump is taking Q2 amount of heat from the heat sink and supplying Q2 amount of heat to the heat source. Okay, now what is happening? This heat engine is producing W net, and here W net equals to Q1. Means actually this heat engine is taking Q1 amount of heat from the heat source, but rejecting no heat to the surrounding. Q2 equal to zero means there is no heat rejected to the surrounding. So here it is violating the Kelvin-Planck statement. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, it is violating the, because Q2 equal to zero. So it is taking Q1 amount of heat and producing the same amount of work, violating the Kelvin-Planck statement. Now suppose this amount of work produced by the heat engine is given to the heat pump. We are giving this work to the heat pump. So this heat pump, which is taking Q2 amount of heat from the heat sink, will take W net, that is Q1 amount of the work from the heat engine, and will supply Q2 plus Q1 amount of heat to the heat source.
Source.
Clear?
So actually this is the Q2 equal zero.
This we have taken, we have assumed it, because we have to violate the Kelvin-Planck statement. We have to violate the Kelvin-Planck statement, otherwise it will not violate it.
Yes, sir.
Violating here the Kelvin-Planck. Kelvin-Planck means, you can say, that is connected to the heat engine. Kelvin-Planck means heat engine. Okay? So you can see there is a combined system. Now what is happening here? Combined A. I will draw it here. So this is the combined system of the heat engine and the heat pump. This is T1, and here we are having the heat sink here. Heat sink at temperature T2. Now just see here how this combined system is working. You will see, because here Q2 equals to zero, so we are giving this amount of heat to the heat source. Okay, we are giving Q2 plus Q1 to heat to the heat source, but we are taking this amount of heat from the heat source. So what is the net effect? What we are taking is Q2 plus Q1 minus Q1.
Okay,
minus Q1. So it means because Q2 plus Q1 is the greater value. This is the greater value. Okay, it means we are giving or transferring Q2 amount of heat to the heat source. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Q1 we are taking. Okay, yeah, hai na? Now from the heat sink, what we are taking? We are taking Q2 amount of heat from the heat sink. So I can draw here a system. I am not showing what is the name of the system, but here we are taking Q2 amount of heat from the heat sink.
Heat sink.
Yes. So Q2 amount of heat is being taken, and the same heat is being supplied or transferred to the heat source from lower temperature to higher temperature, and this is called as the heat pump. As we know that heat pump takes the heat from the low temperature reservoir and transfer to the high temperature reservoir.
High temperature.
But there is no work input necessary. There is no work input is there. It means this combined system will function as the heat pump. This combined system will function as the
heat pump
without requiring any work input. So this is, it is the violation of Clausius statement. It is the violation of
Clausius statement.
Yeah. Violation of Clausius statement, because we have violated the Kelvin statement, then we have got that it is also violating the Clausius statement. Yes. Got it? Initially we have violated this. We have violated this one. It has violated this Clausius statement. So these both are same. Okay. Now
yes, sir.
Yeah. Now in the second term we are taking, we will violate the Clausius statement. Okay. So second, we are violating Clausius statement. Violating Clausius statement. Okay, violating Clausius statement. What will happen in this case? Just we will see. You will check it. Again, the same. There is a heat source. This is at temperature T1, and there is the heat sink.
T2.
Yeah, heat sink. And this heat sink at temperature T2. The earlier that we have taken. Now, and here we are taking heat pump. Definitely is directionally from heat sink to heat source. So this will take Q2 amount of heat from here, and there is the heat engine. It will take some heat. Suppose I will write here, it is taking the heat as a Q1, and then it is that it this will be Q2. So actually, in this case, we will violate this. means the heat sink is taking Q2 amount of heat and supplying, suppose Q2 amount of heat to the heat source. So here we are violating the clause's statement. Got it? Here we are violating. Yes, now this heat engine, it will produce W net because it is not violating. We are only violating here clause's statement. So and this will be equal to Q1 minus Q2 work done.
Q2
minus Q2. Any doubt?
No,
okay. So here we are violating. Here we are violating. Now what happens here? This produced work by the heat engine is supplied to this heat pump.
Heat pump.
We are connected both together. Okay. Then this combined system will work, and what will be its effect? Now see here, at the sink side, the interaction with the sink, we are seeing that Q2 heat is being supplied or transferred to the heat sink, and the same amount of heat is being taken from the heat sinks. Okay, it means if we connect these two together, here, there is no need of the heat sink. Because Q2 we are giving to the heat sink and Q2 we are also taking from the heat sink. So what is the need of the heat sink? This energy rejected by the heat engine is given to the heat pump.
Yes, sir.
Clear?
Heat
engine is rejecting Q2 amount heat to the heat sink, means this amount of heat, you can say, you understand, plus one and minus one equal to zero.
Yes, sir.
So Q2 amount of heat we are giving, and the amount of heat being taken from the same heat, same reservoir, so it is not needed. Then we can connect heat engine with the heat pump. This will become the our combined system. Now see here. Heat source. So actually in this case, there will be only one thermal reservoir. We are not having the heat sink. Now what is happening? Q1 amount of heat is being taken and Q2 amount of heat being given to the heat source. Q1 is greater than Q2. So net amount will be, we can say, the Q1 minus Q2 amount of heat is being taken from the heat source. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Q1 we are taking and Q2 we are giving. The difference is the
Q1. Yes, sir.
And what is the work done? Work done is the Q1 minus Q2 as per the earlier. Because it's a command system, we are producing only this amount of work. That is Q1 Q2. So this engine is producing W net equal to
what? Q1 minus Q2.
Yeah, but what is the meaning of this? The meaning of this? This is working as a heat engine. Because heat engine producing the work. This is the combined system.
Yes, sir.
This is the combined system. Tell me, please, tell me, what is the meaning of this? Now you have to answer. What is happening here? What is happening? No.
No.
Actually, Q here in this case, Q equal to Q1 minus Q2. Any doubt?
No, sir.
And W is equal to, that is also Q1 minus Q2.
Q1 minus Q2.
Means what?
Yes, sir.
Means we are converting full amount of heat into work.
Yes, sir.
And full amount of heat is being converted into work. It is following. Yes, it is as per the first law, but not as per the second law. As per the first law, we can fully convert heat into work, but as per the second law, can we convert?
No, sir.
So actually, it is violating which statement? Kelvin-Planck statement.
Yes, sir.
This is for the heat engine. Okay. So if we are violating the Clausius statement, it will also violate the Kelvin-Planck statement. It will also violate the Kelvin-Planck statement. It be okay. here the it is the Kellogg-Plank statement violation. So it has it is proved that if we violate one statement, another statement will be automatically violated. So even it seems that both are the statement are different, but actually not. All the both the statement are the same. Is it clear? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Is it clear? So now I am going.